Hello, my dear student. I am Professor Devashish Bose, Head Department of Criminology and Forensic Science, Dr. Hari Singh Gaur Vishwavidyalaya, Sagar, Madhya Pradesh. Today, I am going to present a lecture of BSc first semester on the unit State Police Organization, which has been jointly prepared by myself and Ms. Hemlata Bambade, a PhD scholar and a UGC GRF at Department of Criminology and Forensic Science, Dr. Hari Singh Gaur Vishwavidyalaya, Sagar. Module 1 will be Introduction to State Police Organization. Module 2, Meaning of Police Term and Characteristics of Police. Module 3, Explanation of Different Gadgeted Officer Ranks of the State Police. Module 4, Organizational Structure of State Police. Module 5, Role of State Police. And finally, Module 6 will be our conclusion. I think we are always fascinated with the uniformed police of whichever state they belong to. They fascinate us. So, the state police, simply known as state police services, are police services under the control of respective state governments of the state and union territory of India. The candidates are usually posted as deputy superintendent of police or assistant commissioner of police once their probational period ends. Each state and territory has a state police force and its own distinct state police service headed by the Commissioner of State Police or Director General of Police, commonly known as DGP, who are from Indian Police Services. The state police is basically responsible for maintaining law and order in the areas of the state and the urban or the rural areas. The major cities have their own police force known as Metropolitan Police. Do you know about that? Which is quite similar to other normal police forces except their different rank and designation. Example, DGP is called as Commissioner of Police. Metropolitan Police, the IPS, is not a law enforcement agency in its own right. Rather, it is the body to which all senior police officers of the state belongs regardless of the agency for whom they work. The recruitment to the CIS services is done by the respective state governments, usually through public service commissions. Some of the posts are recruited by Staff Selection Commission. The staff conducted the exam all over India and recruit according to the eligibility. The recruitment to SPS is also on the same pattern as that of IPS. The only difference is that the recruitment of SPS officers is made by State Public Service Commission, concerned through usually a combined competitive examination for state civil services, which is the case of IPS, is through the All India Civil Services Examination, conducted by UPSC. However, in case of Union Territory, recruitment to SPS is also made by Union Public Service Commission through the Civil Services Examination as one of the Group A, that is Junior Branch Services. State police requirement is larger state like Tamil Nadu, the state of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, Maharashtra is greater as compared to small states like Chhattisgarh, Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, Jharkhand, Punjab, Haryana, Sikkim and Northeastern state. After selection, which again is based upon the choice of a service and the merit of the candidate, selected candidates are required to undergo vigorous probationary training before getting posted as ACP or DSPs. The term police is associated with a person who takes part in law enforcement empowered by the government. The police is a unit of constituent body which is called police force, constituted to enforce the law, protect property and limit civil disorder. The term is most commonly associated with police service of sovereign state that are authorized to exercise the police power of that state within a defined legal or territorial area of responsibility. Police forces are often defined as being separate from military or other organization involved in the defense of the state against foreign aggressions. However, gendarmeries are military units charged with civil policing. The best police officers or law enforcement officers are unselfish and altruistic types To take on the responsibilities of a police officer, they need a burning desire to help people and to safeguard their well-being and property. Generally, law enforcement officers feel a duty to their community and want to make a difference for its citizens. The main characteristics are highlighted below. Honest and dedicated. The most important characteristics of a police officer is honesty and dedication towards his duty. He should not only work for the wealth, but also the honesty and ethical emotions should be above all wealth. Health. Police officers should be physically as well as mentally healthy so that he can take prompt decision and action at the time of crime to get positive results in his investigational work. He should have a good and sharp memory, be aware about do's and don'ts, and avoid the intoxication during duty. Unbiased. Police officers should be unbiased. He should not take the side of any one party without any solid evidence against the opposite party. The presence of a bias can make the wrong decision an injustice with the victim. Ability to judge a person. The police officer should be able to judge a person so that he may not be misguided by the wrong and confusing statement of a suspect. Knowledge. A police officer should have a proper knowledge about the procedure of police and court, as well as rules and regulation. He or she should be also introduced with whole procedure and staples of investigation of crime, including protection and preservation of crime scene, as well as about proper evidence collection, handling, all types of available facility, corpus delicti, local culture of the area, etc., etc. Patience, persistence, and tireless capacity to work. The complex case need more time, hard work, and curiosity to uncover the typical criminal cases. These features are most important for solving complex situation of case, which may be made complex by the suspect to misguide the police officer. So this is very important. Capacity of avoidance of inaccurate conclusion. This is very important. Please pay attention. The police officer must have the quality to avoid the injustice and increase of criminal activities in society. He should not make any decision or conclusion without knowing the truth, reason, or solid evidence. Correct observation. The proper observation is a master key to unlock the complexity of the case. This is the skill of concentration. The mind towards the small thing should as suspect way talking, walking, expression, get up, vehicle number, etc., which may be helpful in avoiding the misguidance to wrong direction. Suspicious. A best police officer must have the characteristic of suspicious. That means he should suspect everyone. The character is helpful to grip the actual culprit or criminal cases. Police can realize the person only in presence of solid evidence of innocence of that person, but not in absence of evidence against any person. Adaptability and bravery. Police officers should be adaptable according to situation, whether negative or positive. He should be dare and brave in worst to worst condition cases and should not lose hope of uncovering a case. The Indian Police Service uses insignia or badges on its shoulder, flashes which are similar to those used by the Indian Army. Since police inspectors are officers below the rank and are recruited by states individually, the insignias vary slightly through the rank structure in the same. For example, Maharashtra Police Constable use yellow epaulette on blue background for constable ranks, while Tamil Nadu Police use black chevrons on red background on right sleeves. Gadgeted officers belong to Indian State Police Service, lies below the rank of ACPs or DCPs and DCP or SSP. Deputy Commissioner of Police or Senior Superintendent of Police, DCP or SSP in India, a District Senior Superintendent of Police, SSP or Superintendent of Police, SP, heads the police force of a district. In metropolitan areas having police commissionate system like Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, the head of the district police is called Deputy Commissioner of Police, and he holds the rank of a SP or SSP. Superintendent of Police are most officers of the Indian Police Services. They are entrusted with the powers and responsibilities of maintaining law and order and related issues of their respective districts of a state or a union territory of India. They are assisted by officers of state police services and other police officers. Their rank or badges in the state emblem above 1 star. Although just before becoming DIG, that is almost in their 14th year of service, and in big cities like Lucknow, where the post itself is SSP, they wear the state emblem above 2 stars. The rank below is the additional deputy commissioner of police or additional superintendent of police, where the rank above is deputy inspector general of police or commonly known as DIG, who bears a Ashoka Chakra above 3 stars. The rank of district superintendent of police is equivalent to rank of commandant, that is CO, in CAPF or colonel of the Indian Army. Deputy Commissioner of Police or Superintendent of Police, DCP or SP. In India, a District Superintendent of Police, SP or Deputy Commissioner of Police, DCP, heads the police force of a district. Superintendents of Police are officers of the elite Indian Police Services. Their rank badge is the state emblem above 1 star, although those selected for higher ranks or with 15 years or more service become Senior Superintendent of Police SSP or Deputy Commissioner of Police, who wears the state emblem above 2 star. The rank below it is the Additional Deputy Commissioner of Police or Additional Superintendent of Police ASP. In the state of Kerala, Superintendents of Police in charge of the district are called District Police Chief. Additional Deputy Commissioner of Police or Additional Superintendent of Police. Additional Superintendent of Police or Additional Deputy Commissioner of Police is still in use in India, where the officers holding this rank can be from Indian Police Service or from the Indian State Police Services. Additional Superintendent of Police or Additional Deputy Commissioner of Police wears only a national emblem on their shoulders. The rank above it is Superintendent of Police or Deputy Commissioner of Police, and the rank below it is Deputy Superintendent of Police or a Assistant Commissioner of Police. An Additional Superintendent of Police is usually in charge of a large urban area within a district or is a deputy commander of an armed forces or a special commando battalion. Additional Superintendent can be in charge of a subject matter under a district SP, such as traffic, intelligence, operations or headquarters. In all appoints, he reports to the district superintendent or the commandant of the battalion. IPS officers usually reach the rank of additional SP after 5 years of service, while state service officer reaches the rank after 7 years of their service. Assistant Commissioner of Police or Deputy Superintendent of Police. Deputy Superintendent of Police is a rank used by police forces in India who wears 3 stars on their shoulder, which is same insignia as a captain in the Indian Army, pay band of the lieutenant. It was also used by the British Empire. The rank is a higher than Assistant Superintendent and is equivalent to Assistant Commissioner of Police in the commissionerate system. Deputy Superintendents are state police officers who belong to the provincial police force, either direct entrant at the rank or promoted from inspector. Assistant Commissioner of Police, who are members of the provincial forces, can be promoted to the IPS after a particular limited period of service, which varies from 8 to 15 years depending on the state. In the state of Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh, it is known as Circle Officer. In India, candidates who are Indian citizens with any degree within the age of 21 to 38 years are eligible. There is a minimum physical requirement of height for men and for women respectively, which are different. Chest requirement are also different for men and women. And they are also different in state. Every year, the state government prepares a list of members of the state police service to be suitably promoted to the Indian police service. Officers recruited by state PSC directly get this rank. Superintendence over the police force in the state is exercised by the state government. The head of the police force is the Director General of Police, commonly known as DGP, who is responsible to the state government for the administration of the police force in the state and for advising the government on different police matters. The state is divided and allotted in sequence to state, zone, range, district, subdivision, circle and police station. States are divided territorially into administrative units known as districts. An officer of the rank of superintendent of police heads the district police force. A group of districts forms a range, which is looked after by an officer of the rank of deputy inspector general of police. Some states have zone comprises two or more ranges under the charge of an officer of the rank of an inspector general of police. Every district is further subdivided into subdivisions. A subdivision is under the charge of an officer of the rank of ASP or deputy SP. Every subdivision is further divided into a number of police stations depending on the area, population and volume or the number of crime taking place. Between the police station and the subdivision, there are police circles. In some states, each circle is headed generally by an inspector of police. A police station is further divided into number of beats, which are assigned to constables for patrolling, surveillance, collection of intelligence, etc. My dear student, I think you have noted around your area, they have mentioned the who is the beat in charge or the beat responsible with his mobile number. And you have might seen the police officers on motorcycles taking round. So they are the beat in charge. The officer in charge of a police station is an inspector of police, particularly in cities and metropolitan areas. Even in bigger places, police station in terms of area, population, crime or the problem of law and order are placed under the charge of an inspector of police. In rural areas or smaller police station, the officer in charge is usually a sub-inspector of police. Director General of Police, DGP, in charge of the state police force. Additional Director General of Police, additional DGP. Inspector General of Police, IGP, in charge of a zone which comprises of few range. Deputy Inspector General of Police, DIG. He is in charge of range which comprises of group of district. Senior Superintendent of Police, SSP, in charge of the bigger district. Superintendent of Police or SP, in charge of a district. Additional Superintendent of Police, additional SP. Assistant Deputy Superintendent of Police, ASP or DYSP, in charge of a subdivision in the district. Inspector of Police, in charge of a police station or a thana. Sub-Inspector of Police, SI, in charge of a smaller thana or a smaller police station. Assistant Sub-Inspector of Police, he is a staff of the police station, the main staff. Police Head Constable, again he is a staff of a particular police station. Police Constable, staff of a police station. The role and function of the state police are as follows. They have to uphold and enforce the law impartially and protect the life, liberty, property, human right and dignity of the members of the public. Promotes and preserves public order. Protects internal security. Prevents and controls terrorist activity, Naxal activity, breaches of communal harmony, militant activity and other situations affecting internal security. Protect public property including roads, railways, bridges, vital installation and establishment against the act of vandalism, violence or any kind of attack. prevent crime and reduce the opportunities for commission of crimes through their own preventive action and measures, as well as by aiding and cooperating with other relevant agencies in implementing due measures for prevention of crime. Accurately register all complaints brought to them by a complainant or representative in person or received by post, email, or other means, and take prompt follow-up action thereon after duly acknowledging the receipt of the complaint. Registers and investigate all cognizable offenses committed to their notice or coming to their notice through such complaints or otherwise, duly supplying a copy of the first information report or the FIR to the complainant, and wherever appropriate to apprehend the offenders and extend requisite assistance to the prosecution of offenders. Create and maintain a feeling of security in the community, and as far as possible preventing conflict and promote amenity. They should also provide, as the first responder, all possible help to a people in a situation arising out of natural or man-made disaster, and to provide assistance to other agencies in relief and rehabilitating measures. Aids individual who are in danger of physical harm to their person or property, and to provide necessary help and effort relief to the people in distress situation. Facilitates orderly movement of people and vehicle, and to control and regulate traffic flow on the roads and highways. Collect intelligence input related to matters affecting public peace and all kind of criminal activities, including social offenses, communalism, extremism, terrorism, Naxalism, and other matters related to national security, and disseminates the same to all concerned agencies beside acting as appropriate on its themselves. Takes charge as a police officer on duty of all unclaimed property and takes action for their safe custodial and disposal in accordance with the proposal or procedure prescribed therein. Trains, motivates, and ensures welfare of police personnel. Police are one of the universal organization of our society. The policeman, therefore, happens to be the most visible representative of the government. In an hour of need, danger, crisis, and difficulty, when a citizen does not know what to do, whom to approach, the police station and the policeman happens to be the most appropriate and approachable unit and person for the person in distress. The police are expected to be the most accessible, interactive, and dynamic organization of any society. Their roles, functions, and duties in the society are natural to be varied and diverse on the one hand, and complicated and complex on the other hand. Broadly speaking, the twin role which the police are expected to play in a society for the maintenance of law and maintenance of order. However, the complications of these two duties are numerous, which results in making a large inventory of duties, functions, powers, roles, and responsibility of police organization. With all these information here, we come to the end of this informative lecture. Do keep in mind what we have discussed today. It's time for you all to do some self-study. This is Professor Devashish Bose signing off for today. If you want to learn more and enhance your knowledge, you may log on to our website for MCQs, quizzes, and LORs at www.cec.nic.in. Till then, goodbye.